Hello children, good morning. In the last video, I explained you how the hunter-gatherers develop from gathering stage to food-producing stage. We are discussing in that lesson. I stopped. Where did they store those seeds and grains? I stopped that lesson there. Now, what are the animals are store by them? How did they keep those animals? Let us discuss in this video. Storing animals. Animals multiply naturally. All the animals multiply naturally. Besides, if they are looked after carefully, if you are looking carefully those animals, they provide us milk and food, meat. These are all things for you. Milk is very important food for us, and meat and eggs. These are all whatever required. These are all things provided by the animals to you. In other words, animals that are reared can be used as a store of food. We are all eating the meat of animals also. So, like this, the early people, they stored some of the animals. What are the animals you are eating now? Eating animals and pet animals, wild animals, you prepare a list. Next one, finding out about the first farmers and herders. How did you know about the first farmers and herders? What are the sources? Those sources are found in which areas? Now discuss these areas. Archaeologists have found evidences of early farmers and herders in some areas. In your textbook, page number 14, open. In that, you will notice some of the blue squares areas are given. These mark sites archaeologists found evidences of early farmers and herders. These are found all over the subcontinent. Entire our India, the archaeologists found these areas. Some of the most important ones are in the northwest, in the present day Kashmir, Pakistan, some areas also they found evidences of the early farmers and herders. Some are in east, some are in south. To find out whether these sites were settlements of farmers and herders, scientists study evidences of plants and animals' bones. One of the most exciting finds includes remains of burnt grain. Burnt grain was found by the archaeologists. Scientists can identify these grains, and so we know that a number of crops were grown in different parts of the subcontinent. Yes, here some areas archaeologists found the burnt grains. Why did they burn grains? Ash mounds were founded by our archaeologists. Immediately, scientists identify these grains. So they understood in the early days, those members know very well in farming. They can also identify the bones of different animals. Different types of animal bones also found in one area. So, in those areas, maybe those members, the early herders, constructed the herds. In this textbook, in your textbook, page number 25, one table is given to you, children. Open that. Page number 25, that table. In which areas the archaeologists found the evidences and sources? One area is given in that page. One by one I will explain. Observe that. Mehgar, it is one of the area located in Pakistan. In that area, early people grown wheat, barley, and sheep, cattle, goat was also known by these people. Some of the evidences founded by the archaeologists in Mehgar state. Koldia, the second one is Koldia. This area is in present day Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh state, Koldia is there. In that area, people know the cultivation of rice, fragmentary animals, bones were founded by the archaeologists. Mahagara, the third one is Mahagara. In this area, now it is also located in Uttar Pradesh. Here, archaeologists found rice, cattle, and hoof masks of clay surfaces also. Next, Gufkal. Gufkal. Present day it is in Kashmir. Wheat and lentils. Those two crops grown by the early people in this site, Gufkal. Next, Burjahan. Next site is Burjahan. Now it is in Kashmir. Wheat and lentil, these two are grown in this area, and those people tamed the animals like dog, cattle, sheep, goat, buffalo. After that, Chirand. Chirand, it is located now Bihar state. Here people grown wheat, green grams, barley, and their tamed animals were buffalo and ox. Next, Hallur. Hallur, it is located in our state, Andhra Pradesh. Here people cultivated millets, and their tamed animals were cattle, sheep, goat, and pig. Last one is Payampalli. Payampalli, it is also located in our Andhra Pradesh. Black grams, millets are cultivated by those people, and cattle, sheep, pig. These animals are reared by the people in those days. Now, come to the 31 page. Here, second question. Look at the table on page number 25. If Numunu wanted to eat rice, which are the places she should have visited? Okay. Now, you write the answer of this question also. Okay, children. Have you understood this? Children, in this video, I explained some important places in our Andhra Pradesh, and some are in other countries also. Where did those people cultivated, which type of crops are known by them, which type of crops they grown in those areas, the archaeologists found sites I explained. The next lesson, I will continue the same lesson. Thank you.